Hi, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today I'm finally harvesting selective seeds from some of our flowers. I wanted to start with our peony trees. Now these we bought several years ago at the farmer's market, and you can see I left just a few of the flower heads on there so that we could see if we could harvest some of those seeds. Now the trick is getting them off without dumping the seeds out. All right, let me see if these are even in here. I don't think any of these are still there. See, they've all escaped from me. I possibly waited too long with these particular ones. Okay, let me try this one. I'm gonna have to look inside the pods. And these are very large seeds, so they're very noticeable if they're there. And they are not. They have escaped. Luckily, I picked some earlier, so I know I do have some of these.
So the seeds would be inside of each of those little...
Right. There would be at least one big seed inside there. These seem to be all gone. Well, let me show you what they look like when I got them earlier. They are this big. They're shiny and they're black.
Now, were those off this one here?
Mm-hmm. They were off this one. Then this is the pink one over here. And again, I think they've all popped out of here already. But I was able to catch some earlier. Again, you'd never know by the looks of them that they were different from the other ones, but I know which one they got them off of. So those are those. And it's important that you mark which is which, because like I said, they look the same. So unless you mark them, you'll never know. I'm putting them in paper so that they can dry out nicely. If I wanted these to sprout next year, I would have to put them in the ground now so that they would go through the freezing season and then they'd be ready to germinate in the spring. If I didn't allow that, they probably wouldn't germinate.
Well, did you want to use one of our raised beds? We talked about using one of the raised beds for flowers. Do you want to have that as kind of a breeding ground?
We could. Of course, we do have a whole bed of peony trees.
I know.
So that's a possibility.
But we can keep those separate and we'll know where they came from.
Yes, we would. These would be our own. So.
Okay. Well, what other seeds have you cultivating?
I am collecting the white hardy hibiscus, the ones that get 6 feet tall and the size of a dinner plate, and also yucca. I've had two people request seeds from those particular plants, so those are the ones that I want to show where they come from and how they look.
Now, is there any regulations against sending seeds out of state? I know, like, when you go to California, you can't bring things in.
Right. Well, it depends on where you are. You're right. You can't bring them in a lot of times to Arizona or Florida or California or Hawaii because they don't want any possible diseases or insects. So you have to be careful, and I'm hoping that people that have made the request, I know they don't live in those states.
Okay. Very good. Well, let's go see what else you're harvesting.
Okay. These are the hardy hibiscus, and yes, they grow in Wisconsin. Each of these was a flower, a big, huge white flower, as big as a dinner plate almost. And they are very prolific seeders. This one will not be done. That one obviously has not matured to the point where it would grow.
Well, we've already had two nights of below freezing, so.
Yes. So you can see these are all dried out. You break these open, and inside are those small, round seeds. Now, you would think with the amount of seeds that this plant produces, that we would now have a forest of these, but we don't. I have noticed that there are some babies that are growing from these seeds from last year, but I'm guessing it has to be just the right conditions each year to have them grow under the mother plant, let's say.
Well, I'm sure the squirrels and birds, you know,
I'm sure they
are feeding
at
this time of year.
Little mice, yes.
Yep.
But this is the perfect time, a dry day, a sunny day, come out and harvest your seeds. Again, these being native, or not native, but acclimated to this climate, these would have to go through a frozen time, just like the tree peonies would. They expect to be frozen part of the year, and when spring comes, they will then be triggered to sprout.
Well, they require it.
Mm-hmm.
That's why a lot of people keep their seeds in a freezer or refrigerator for a period of time, just basically to take it through that particular level of the season.
That's right. That's right. Okay, on to the yuccas.
Okay.
Now, this is the yucca that we were talking about. This also is hardy for Wisconsin. If you look at the ground here, Rick, this is the yucca. It has leaves similar to an iris, except you can tell it's got these little hairy edges to it, and they're very pokey. If you bump into them, you know you've bumped. Then, now and again, when the conditions are right and the plant is mature enough, it will send up this huge stalk, and they can get even taller than this, and it'll have white blossoms on it, very attractive to the bees and the moths, and then eventually will be these seed pods. And again, you want to harvest them on a day that is dry. I've already harvested some just to be sure I had some. But when you open these up, these are prolific also. Let me dump them in my hand. And it's the black ones that are the seeds, the viable seeds. Again, these will have to freeze in order to sprout for next year. Take this one off. Now, I started with one yucca plant here. I think I now have at least six. This must be the most mature one because this is the only one that had a blossom on it this year.
There's another one right there.
Anybody else?
What's that thing on the top?
One.
Well, that's probably an immature one. Didn't grow quite enough to have seeds.
Take it in and I want to see what's inside of it.
All right.
Well, let's go inside and
this is rather nippy out here.
Yeah.
Another seed I collected early in the summer was this allium. You probably saw them in the springtime. They come up about the time that the tulips come up, and they have this very tall shoot on them, and then this beautiful purple ball of flowers all around. And that's what this is from. They come in all different sizes and heights, but this is the giant one.
Well, that's part of the onion family, right?
That's right. Mm-hmm. Now, if you were collecting these and you just wanted to plant more of them or have more of them come up, I would just take it, put it down on the ground and step it down into the soil and just let them plant themselves more or less about this time of year. Next spring they would come up, they would be tiny little leaves, probably. Not a flower, but just the leaf. And the bulb underneath the ground then would develop each year, getting a little bigger and a little bigger, and eventually you'd end up with the huge purple ball on the top.
I mean, that is bigger than your head.
And some people use these as decoration, too,
yeah.
Because you could spray paint it or do whatever you want in a dry bouquet, it would be very beautiful.
Could spray them with gold paint or
mm-hmm.
silver paint for holidays.
Sure. Put ribbons around them.
Sure.
You've seen them, I'm sure. So the way you get these off then, if you're going to separate them and share them, if you didn't want to give them the whole head, you would take off just that little flower head, and those little black seeds in there are what's going to grow into the new plant. just like that.
Yeah.
So it's a task that is worth it, but I think what I will do with these other guys is just stamp them into the ground where I want them.
There you go.
Faster.
Well, it's an excuse to go dancing outside, right?
That's right. This is an area that has plants that show up later in the year, so this would be a great place to put these. And I'm just going to take them and stamp them down and hope that the squirrels and the birds don't find them before they plant themselves into the ground. I do this also with sunflowers. This is how I plant sunflowers.
Well, you could take your frustrations out too, I suppose.
Sure.
Planting seeds. Linny Appleseed. Oh no. These aren't apple seeds.
No, they're
not. That is a cute dance you're doing though.
Thank you. There you go. Much faster. Now that we're inside and it's a little bit warmer, I can show you better what they look like when you bring them in. Now, I don't like to do this in the house, only because sometimes there's little flies and insects and things on them, and I really don't want to expose my house plants to it. But then you would just, you know, shovel those little seeds right out of there.
And these are from?
These are the hardy white hibiscus.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
The tall 6-foot plants that grow here in Wisconsin.
Yeah, they are incredible. I think we got our first one, what, maybe 4 years ago?
Mm-hmm.
From Montez Farms,
yes.
Which is kind of a specimen
nursery.
Plant nursery.
And you'll have plenty that you can share with other people, as you can see. Then these can go in the compost pile, actually. They don't have any seeds in them and roughage.
Oh, that one little, I shouldn't even call it a little plant anymore, that literally produces thousands of seeds.
Yes.
So, considering that little seed produces this giant plant with these incredible flowers that they only bloom for one day and then they disappear. Now, we have one that's pink, one that's red, and one that's white.
Yes. The white one being the largest of them all.
So why would a person, first of all, want to harvest seeds? I mean, what's the objective?
Well, on many plants that we have, I take the seeds off so that the plant will go into the energy will go into the roots of the plant and make them stronger. With a hibiscus, it would be a never-ending task because one hibiscus plant could have 20 blossoms a day. And chopping them off every day would just be overwhelming. So you would harvest them if you wanted to share them with others, or if you wanted to start them someplace else in the yard and you didn't want to disturb the plant that you already had. Or if you were afraid perhaps that the plant was getting old and you didn't want to be lost without it for the next year, you might want to save the seeds for yourself and start all over again.
Well, it is something you do have to allow for enough room for that plant to really develop and grow, because it does get big.
That's right.
I mean, I'm 6'2", and that plant is sometimes over a foot taller than I am. I mean, it's just constantly blooming, constantly.
Right. So I'm putting them in just a plain white envelope. I will leave it open until they're nice and dry to make sure no mold grows on them, mold or mildew. And then I will leave them out on this porch for the whole winter because it will get below freezing here and that will be a good environment for it. Now,
well, you could just poke a hole, you know, with a paper punch at the top of that lid and just hang it.
Yes. Yep. Do that. Like this.
Mm-hmm.
Now for the yucca, usually I do not collect the yucca seeds. I will chop those off because I really don't want any more yuccas. Once you plant a yucca, you have it for a long time because it will send out roots and it will just keep spreading. It's not a fast spreader, it's slow, but it's hard to get rid of once you have one. So I will just chop those off before they drop to the ground. But since I had a request for them, I thought, well, it might be kind of fun just to see how many seeds there are on a yucca. So these are ones that I collected before, and you can see this was 3-4 buds on this one stalk. And I suppose I could just do this, it'd be easier, but in order to get them all.
Well, those two are very prolific. Amazing
yes,
how
are.
Mother Nature has her plan intact, preserving species.
Yes, indeed. And again, if you let all of them fall into your yard, you could end up with a whole forest of them.
Well, then you start your own nursery and start selling yucca plants.
They are an impressive plant. They're a good specimen plant, especially if you have a place that is dry and sunny and other things don't like to grow there, the yucca will grow there. It's not
doesn't need the richest
about,
soil in the world.
No, it does not. Now see, this one,
it's like they didn't mature.
Right, or they dried out too much. So, you know, you can be selective. In fact, I would encourage you to be selective. Those are fine.
And you collected all of these already, right?
Yes, I did.
That's a sizable...
That is a sizable amount.
A little bucket of seeds.
Indeed. I could be here all afternoon doing this.
Yes, you could. Okay, well... So now you've got the yucca seeds, the hibiscus, and
the tree peonies.
The tree peonies.
Yes.
So, be
not
interesting.
Not very many tree peonies. But
right. Be interesting getting them in the ground and seeing what happens.
Yes. Well, and the reason we don't have many tree peonies is because I trimmed most of those flowers off, again, because I wanted the root to be stronger. I wanted all the energy that tree peony had going into root to make it a stronger plant. I don't need another tree peony because we are trying to grow our own from seeds that we bought from someone else. So that was my reason. And I'll stick to it.
Okay.
If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. We'd love to hear from you. Thank you for watching us, for your comments, suggestions and tips. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, please subscribe.
And if you harvest seeds, we'd love to hear about it and see what kind of seeds you're harvesting.
Yes.
It's a good time of year to do that.
Yes, it is.
Put your winter coat on. Us Northlanders.
Yes, well, at least we have not had any snow yet.
Now, I notice we've always lived in Wisconsin, but you're wearing a San Francisco jacket. Are you defecting?
No, I'm not, but when we visited in San Francisco, it was so cold, I had to buy a jacket to wear because I was freezing.
Oh.
And that was in April.
Okay. Well, let's get back to our seeds here. Could you eat them?
You would have to do some studying on that. I don't know. I wouldn't.
No.
Don't go putting things
like,
in. No, not pumpkin seeds. No, you need to do your homework about that.
Okay.